Robert, I want to read you a list of the top 10 greatest athletes of all time. Let me know who would you put on this list, okay? Michael Jordan, number one. Messi, two. Kobe, three. Brady, four. Tyson, five. Wayne Gretzky, six. Tiger Woods, seven. Floyd Mayweather, eight. Sean O'Malley, nine. And Roger Federer, 10.
I think one that's missing is Cristiano Ronaldo.
Who else? Michael Phelps?
Nah, because he got a lot of shit because of, you know, smoking pot. Oh,
what's wrong with that? It made him a better swimmer, no?
Huh?
Okay, what about Muhammad Ali?
Is that there?
What about Maradona? Wouldn't you put him over Messi?
But he it's because he, towards the end of his career, he was, you know, fucking around too much and all that. So I think all that counts, right? Mayweather never fucked up. You know, Messi hasn't fucked up.
He's now still playing.
I think, but I like Cristiano Ronaldo better, man. I think he's a fucking great athlete, great fucking role model, great example of how to become the best by taking care of your body, your health, you know, resting, sleeping, all that. You know, he's a perfect example. Mayweather's another one.
Khabib doesn't smoke, doesn't drink.
I don't even know what that is.
Pita, is Khabib one of the 10 greatest athletes ever?
No.
What about Nate Diaz?
I don't know who Khabib is.
UFC star.
UFC star?
Yeah, 28-0 in the UFC.
Oh,
he's retired.
Oh, yeah? He's the only one that retired undefeated.
I think so, yeah.
I've never seen an MMA guy undefeated.
Yeah. No, it's true.
Right?
Yeah, you could lose any fight at any moment. Someone could choke you out, kick you, knock you out. Not an easy sport.
Yeah.
What about Bo Jackson? He was pro in three different sports. Baseball, football, and track?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
What about Usain Bolt? Would you put him as one of the greatest ever?
It's hard to fucking say who. You know, if you ask me, I know soccer.
Yeah.
And I know boxing. So if you ask me about soccer, I don't think Cristiano Ronaldo, Messi, Cuauhtémoc Blanco got to be there, too.
That's one of the greatest athletes ever.
Cuauhtémoc Blanco got to be there.
He's the greatest in Mexico or greatest athlete, period? Did he play for Manchester United or something?
Nah, but in Mexico, yeah, he's the best of all time.
Very popular.
Very popular, yeah.
What about Chavez Sr.?
Chavez Sr. is a great athlete.
It was 89-0 at some point.
It was. We had, we had like Rafa Marquez, who did a lot more than Cuauhtémoc Blanco, but I was really quiet, you know, never into no fucking scandals or anything. Cuauhtémoc was always in those things.
Yeah, but it made it popular.
Hugo Sanchez was probably the best of all time in Mexico. He played many years for Real Madrid. But I just, you know, Cuauhtémoc is just...
What about Memo? You took a picture with Memo.
Memo Choa, that was a great one.
Best goalkeeper ever.
One of the best.
What about LeBron James? One of the greatest athletes of all time?
I'm not a big fan of LeBron James.
Yeah, I know. People who know him are not fans of his. Only people who don't know him.
Yeah.
Sometimes the image, the media will make people your fans. But if you meet him...
You know, when it comes to the best of all, the GOAT, or the best, the greatest of all time, you don't have to just look at how much they've scored, how many titles they won. Best of all time also means outside, you know, how smart were you outside, you know, because you could be the best of all time. You could be the best in one sport, but be a fucking asshole and a dick and a fucking total piece of shit outside, and that'll make you the GOAT. That'll make you the greatest of all time.
It's a turnoff.
Exactly. So, you know, a lot of times, it's just the way it is. You know, Jordan, I'm not saying he's been perfect either, but everybody wears Jordans. Everybody wears Jordans. I've never seen somebody wearing LeBron James shoes. You know what I mean? It's just the way it is, man.
I have a pair. I don't have them on.
I wouldn't know what they
are. Yeah. No, it's true.
So that's, you know, the way it is, man. The way it is.
But it's exciting. You have a lot of big weekends coming up, Robert. Two fights this weekend.
Yeah, we've been having for the past 5 weeks. And then we have Leo fighting in Florida.
What that card? Who's the card is that? Boxer?
It's August 23rd, huh? 23rd. Box?
Pro box.
It's funny. You're sparring with those?
Yeah.
I usually don't see fighters spar. They always have laces for sparring.
Yeah.
You like them. They're good gloves.
Yeah, they're good gloves.
But usually you don't see with the wrap for sparring.
He's fighting pro box. He's fighting another undefeated guy, but he's
How many rounds now?
This guy's one of the most dedicated fighters in the gym.
I'll tell you that for a fact.
I've seen him run with Manny Pacquiao.
I've seen it in front of everybody else.
That's really good to hear. Keep it that way.
I've seen it in front of everybody else. He's one of the hardest working guys in the gym.
Why do you say that?
He is.
But what does he do different, Robert? What does he do different?
He doesn't train his ass off.
That true, Leo? You don't miss a day. You come in, you're all serious.
And I'll tell you, I just learned this. He never mentioned it. Before he gets here at 10 or at 11, whenever, he already did his fucking work. He has his own lawn mowing company.
Amazing. He's responsible.
Yeah, he goes and does. He works. Has a few houses that he goes and takes care
of. He's very smart.
Smart kid.
Because listen, in boxing, there's no money starting out. And some, you have to be an Olympian for a manager to give you like $1,500 a month.
Yeah,
most fighters don't get that. And you don't fight every month, every week. So you need to pay bills. And I don't know if you have kids, if you're married, whatever. But you need money for insurance, to eat. It's not a cheap. It's very responsible.
I respect his hustle.
So you start at 4 in the morning, 5 a.m.?
I've told
other fighters, you can work at Ralph's, the grocery store. They have a shift 4 a.m. to 8 a.m. And they don't want to do it, Robert. No, I'm a star.
Most of them don't. But he's doing it.
So when you make it, we'll bring in Mark Kriegel and you have a great story. You can say your dad never told you that he loved you. Right?
Yep.
And you had to go mow lawns. But that's good. But it's good that you're dedicated. Because now you know the value.
You have to fucking respect. I'll be there in Florida with him.
A lot of fighters don't want to work, Robert. They just want to trip, which I understand. Because how tired do you get by noon, by 1?
You're tired, but you still fucking got to...
And you take a little nap and you start...
Man up and do your shit. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Leo also works construction with his dad.
I saw that. They have a very good company, by the way.
That's what it takes, man.
But not everybody's willing to sacrifice.
That's what it takes.
Do you ever hear the saying? What do you do?
I have two jobs at two different hotels.
What do you do?
A bartender and a server.
Nice. It's very hard to be a bartender. So you know how to make all the drinks? Who in this gym is the biggest alcoholic right now? No, just one, just one.
What a drink,
bartender.
Like, you know, it's not easy. It's a mix. So if you had to guess, just by looking around, who do you think is like a... No, I'm not starting shit. I'm just interviewing. I'm starting shit.
What's your...
Robert, who in that pass a breathalyzer right now?
If it works from last night, then us three. We went to a comedy show.
That's good. Was it? Who is it performing?
I know. My friend Charles.
Nah, bro.
You drink alcohol? No.
What?
You ever had alcohol?
Have I ever drank alcohol? I'm drunk right now.
My friend Charles. Hey, have you ever drank alcohol? I'm drunk right now.
Because it's not easy to be a bartender, Robert. Those drinks are complicated.
That's right, Charles, right?
Yeah, he is. But you can make...
He's been doing it for 30 years.
Yeah.
Anymore.
And you can make good tips if you're in the right restaurant.
Bill does. He's been doing it for years. I met him.
And he has a good living.
I met him when I was 18.
And he's been doing it since then?
Yeah, he's been doing it since.
So now, if you go fight and you need someone to mix drinks, Robert, you know who could cover it.
Yeah.
And he's young, 18, right? You can't drink alcohol, but you can serve it? That's kind of...
No, he's older than that. He's not 18.
And you just turned 18, no?
No, the one that turned 18 is this guy.
You just turned 18.
Yeah.
Got it. We have a lot of kids that are just starting out.
Más hermanos?